Hey! What's up, kids? Or as you probably prefer, young adults. You're probably all scared, confused, a little bit aroused, and wondering what you're all doing here. Well, have no fear, because Professor T, that's me, is here to guide your fresh young minds. But, feel free to call me Mr. T if you like.
No?
No worries. Well, you might not know anyone yet, but don't worry. By the end of this, we're all going to be best buds. I'm so excited. Anyway, before I get ahead of myself, I know that university can be a scary time. So that's why the University of Flumshlampton has asked me to be the guiding hand that leads you little Red Riding Hood out of the scary forest and away from the big bad wolf that is dropping out. To that end, I gathered a series of YouTube clips that aim to enlighten, inspire, and impassion you all. Well, at least that was the plan. Since the projector's on the fritz and we ain't got no cash to fix it, I've gathered a group of volunteers who have recalled the clips from memory and aim to be as inspiring as the original Oscar-winning actors who starred them. For the first section of our clips, we'll look at the best part about being at the university. Here, we have a total of 735,462.5 societies, including World Peace Society, Amateur Surgery Society, Racketeering Society, and of course, who could forget, Surge Radio. These are a great place to meet new friends and form bonds that can never be broken. Not even by death. Anyway, let's begin this introductory lecture.
To be or not to be, that is the...
What are you doing?
What? That's what it says in the stage directions.
Ah! All right, lads, everyone's about 3 points in, is that right?
Yes, just coming up on 11 o'clock now, boys.
And we all know what that means.
Shots!
Gentlemen, time to take your shot. Ready? Okay. Fire!
Would you like me to add Sam to your contacts list?
Not right now. Should we sit down? Yeah, sure.
Would you like me to play some romantic music?
No.
Oh, go on.
Okay, fine. Alexa!
Playing next.
Next, no liberty!
Alexa, stop! Should we watch some TV?
Yeah, sure. What do you like to watch?
Joe recently enjoyed Avengers Infinity War, although she cried like a little baby when Spider-Man died.
Okay. What else?
She also enjoyed 50 Shades of Grey and Basic Instinct a lot.
Let's watch.
Hey, did you see that video? The look at all these chickens one?
No.
Oh, bloody hell. It's hilarious. We left on that in your search for it.
Yeah.
Joe's recent searches include Netflix, the World Chess Championships, and poor...
Alexa, shut up!
You two should kiss. reminder, your last STI checkup was 1 week and 4 days ago.
Alexa!
You should compliment his hair.
He can hear you, Alexa.
He's not as nice as the last one you brought around.
I'm sorry, she's not great with new people. Cannot.
Just turn her off.
She certainly turned the last boyfriend off. Reminder, you have a message from Tyler.
Who's Tyler?
My ex.
The whore! The whore! She still calls 33 times a day, leaving whiny messages like, I really want to get back together with you. I miss you.
Is this true?
She also calls her mother every evening.
Right, I'm leaving.
No, Sam, we can make this work. Don't go.
Look, no, it's clear. You'd rather be with your little robot than being with me. I can't even... Don't contact me again.
You don't have much luck with dating, Joe, do you?
No, I bloody don't!
Told you this before, Jenny. Oscar's gone to live on a farm.
He's really happy there. He wrote us a letter last week about all the girls he's chasing. We just didn't have enough room for him here. You know, now he's got all the cocaine he could want.
When is Oscar going to come home?
He's really happy at the farm right now. He's been so busy with all the drinking. We don't think he'll be back anytime soon.
Can we go visit him?
Well,
no.
We're going to have to tell her at some point.
Look, no one wants to find out their brother has joined the priesthood. We'll tell her when she's old enough to understand.
Can I get the drum roll, please, Jerome? Improv!
Yes, please!
Improv is when you improvise little scenes with your friends on Good Pal Jerome here. It's like what you and your friends do on the lunch, on the playground every single lunchtime, except the school's paid us to be here. The most important thing is, when we're about to end the scene, we'll both say,
Ansie! Oh, I love Ansie!
Me too.
Why do you love it so much?
It's just like a reset button, you know? Any unwanted tension or awkwardness, it all just goes away. Anything you want to forget?
I like it too. We're gonna start a scene now. I'm gonna be a fish and you can be...
I'll be a French fisherman.
A French fisherman? Ooh. Okay, start scene.
Et je veux jouer en
poisson. Oh no, I'm a little fish. Chase me!
Oh no, I'm a fish! She's gonna
eat me! Okay, and now I'll be a member of the bourgeoisie.
Okay, and
I'll be an Essex babe. Okay. Oh my god! Oh my god, is that a member of the Bijouanese? Oh my god.
Yes, it is.
And see. Oh, that one's really good. I really like that one. I really like that one. Okay, so the next one, what can you do? What can we do? Let's see. Door salesman?
Door salesman.
Door salesman.
Hello, is this the door store?
One more door to come through. And see.
And see.
Right, what about if we do a long one for you? Let's see, let's see.
Let's do a long one.
A long one?
A long one, yeah.
Should we do a long
let's
one?
Let's do a long one.
Okay, I'll be pregnant.
What? Oh, no.
You're embarrassing me. Anyway, he's a dear.
What about after?
All right, and let's see. Okay, I'll be a bad bitch, because I kind of am a bad bitch.
You don't like fag.
I don't.
Talk about the show.
Okay. It's been 14 months.
Jeremiah!
Oh?
I know what you did to my daughter, you're finished.
No, that's sort of...
You've gone away with this for too long. Not anymore.
Oh no. And scene! Oh, that was such a fun scene. Now we're gonna try and do an even longer one for you guys. So Jeremiah, if you wouldn't mind. Jeremiah? Jeremiah? Did you not hear me say and scene? Jeremiah. And scene. And scene. Jeremiah, no. And scene!
Problematic, you don't want to see where it goes.
What do you mean by that?
I'm here. So invested in this relationship, I'd hate to stay still here. I want to see where life takes us. I want to see what our children look like, if you're still beautiful in old age. Though I'm sure you will be. But you want to stay here and never move.
I...
You what? Tell me I'm wrong. Tell me you want to keep going.
You're right. I'm sorry. Things are great now, but I don't think they will be for much longer.
I know it's... Can you at least tell me why?
It's because you're left-handed.
Oh, come on, say it with your chest! Speak up!
It's because you're left-handed!
Oh, no!
You know, it doesn't even bother me, but it does! Every time we work together, you're bumping into me, it's hell!
Then I could change! I could become ambidextrous! I would do that for you!
Besides, you're not so perfect yourself, you know.
Me? Not perfect? I'm dead!
Can you even hear yourself? You wear leg warmers like it's the 80s, whether it's summer or winter. You even wore them to the beach.
That's because you bought them for me.
I didn't buy them. You used my card and bought them for yourself as a present.
This is why I wanted to freeze time, so we wouldn't have to have this conversation.
You know what? You freeze time. I'm going to find someone or someone that really appreciates who I am.
You do that. See, never.
Oh boy, I sure hope someone comes to my 5th birthday party.
Happy birthday! Birthday beat!
Oh, thank you! I do wish you wouldn't hit me though. Why is birthday beats a thing?
Happy birthday! Birthday beats!
Oh, thank you! I don't understand why you keep hurting me though.
Happy birthday! Birthday beats!
Oh god! Oh, thank you! But I am in quite a lot of pain right now, so if you don't just
happy
stop it...
Happy birthday! Birthday bang!
No! It's birthday beats! My name is Will. I like to beat my heat. To the floor of feet.
That's disgusting.
Today we're joined by a guest. Please introduce yourself and tell us a bit about yourself and your cringe experiences.
My name's Potts. Matthew Potts.
That is very cringe.
Yeah, I'd say my earlier this cringe experience would have been back in year six when I accidentally referred to my teacher as Mum.
It's a common one with most of our listeners.
Yeah, but it's at the time I cringed most.
I'm sorry, Matthew, could I interrupt you for a second? This whole business with you and the teacher, how cringe was it exactly? Was it as cringe as this, for instance?
No.
And now, a trailer for a new detective drama.
Sure, I'm annoyed at being a detective in this remote village.
You're the best damn detective we have in this town, and I trust you with my life. But on a much more serious note, I don't trust you at all. That's why I'm waiting to meet your new detective partner.
I'm a no-nonsense rookie who's worked her way up through a male-dominated force.
Damn it, Chief! You know I'm a lone wolf, haunted by divorce and crippled by addiction. I work best alone. We're not going to get along at first, but soon I'll learn to trust you.
And our relationship will be entirely platonic, except for one episode where we have weird sexual tension. It's never mentioned again.
Of course. I'm far too occupied with trying to win back my ex-wife, who has already moved on.
I'm a more serious detective who you've never gotten along with. Also, I've actually been the villain this whole time.
I didn't see this coming at all, despite it being obvious to the audience from the first episode.
We'll put aside our differences and save the chief together.
Yeah.
Now, detective, it seems you overcame your problems to become an even better detective.
Yes.
I'm a mysterious figure from your past. I'll be the villain in season two.
Detective Show, coming soon to BBC One.
Don't those all look like fun? I bet your brain to get stuck in and quit 2 weeks later. Now, let's get serious for a moment. Essays are going to be the bane of your existence. You're going to have to learn how to read, and to write, and buy a thesaurus. I know that's not a kind of dinosaur. Unless you consider books dinosaurs, which some people do. Anyway, with these helpful tips, you'll never have trouble writing an essay ever again.
Oh, for the love of sweet Christ.
Oh, God, what's wrong?
It's this book. What a load of old hogswash.
Oh.
I mean, what the crikey hell were they thinking?
Yeah.
I mean, like, how can they do this to my favourite series?
What a travesty. Fine, ignoring you is not going to work. Do you want to say something?
Okay, so the first one was this amazing political thriller where every character had a ridiculously complex web of alliances and treaties, so it's really obvious from the get-go that all it was going to take was one little spark to set it off, right?
Okay.
So when it does kick off, it's amazing. There are themes of dehumanization, just being a cog in an industrial machine that doesn't care whether you live, die, or achieve your goals, complete revolution in the third act, and also no obvious good or evil. It's like, in the end, they're all as bad as each other, you know?
Right.
And in this bloody sequel, did the author snort a yard of the jazz cabbage or something?
What?
I mean, check this out for lazy writing. Weird bad man with funny moustache kicks off, fights everyone at once, blah blah blah, the end. Where is the nuance in that? Where is the nuance? And it's just such a caricature, and like his only friends are either a raging psychopath with a penchant for imaginative torture, or just some bumming buffoon who can't even stand up to his puny next door neighbour.
Abby.
Yes.
That book series, is it perchance the World War series?
Yes.
Those books, they're not.
They're not what?
They're not fictional, Abby! Those things actually happened, and not that long ago. We're still dealing with all the effects of it, even now.
What? So, you mean it's all true? All the atrocities, 57,000 dead in the first day of the Somme, ethnic warfare in Austro-Hungary, 6 million Jewish people murdered by the Nazis.
I'm afraid so.
God dog's a shit writer then.
Yes, I think it's some of my best work.
Right, well, we just wanted to ask you
about... Is it about all the sugary foods? I was thinking they could encourage unhealthy eating in children.
Well, no.
Is it about the Oompa Loompas? I can see how they could be a bit...
Well, no, actually...
Is it about the songs? I could probably rewrite those.
It was the child torture.
Oh, that...
your Majesty, the peasants, they're revolting.
Don't worry, poor people always smell like that.
Around good guy here. Just letting you know, I wrote that sketch. The subtext is, I hate poor people.
God, I am so bored.
Right? There's just nothing to do.
We could do our essays. They are due in 2 hours.
Well, I look like some kind of nuts.
Don't be stupid. Yeah, you're right. Sorry.
I know what we can do! I've had an idea!
Alright then, go on, what is it?
Okay, so basically, we take the jet.
Right, I'm going to stop you there. Are you saying we start an unjustified war in the Middle East?
Yeah, what's wrong with that?
Do you remember what happened last time?
Oh yeah, Tony got done for war crimes, didn't he? Guess we can't pull that old trick again.
Poor Mr. Blair.
I've got it for real this time! We can play darts!
But what with? We gave our dartboard to charity and used the darts to pop children's balloons.
No, check this out, you silly goose!
That's not a dart, that's a paper plane!
Hush, sweetness.
But we still don't have a dartboard.
We'll use me as the dartboard.
But how? It won't stick into you. We won't know how many points I've got.
Watch this.
See, my darling?
Oh, I think I do.
Ah, wasn't that something? There's a lot you can take away from that. From what I understand, a lot of you are staying in one of the trendy halls the university has to offer, and that's great. But it's never too early to start thinking about where you're going to live next year. Although, there are a few things you should look out for, like your contract, dodgy letting agents, and those filthy swine you're going to call your housemates. But hopefully these little scenarios will teach you a thing, or two.
me a £250, please.
Well, sure, here you go. Thanks for fitting the new door. We badly need it after burglars caved the last one in. Hopefully this new door offers us more protection than the last.
Well, I'm gonna hit the road. Pleasure doing business with y'all.
No, wait. Hold your horses. Let's admire your handiwork first.
Well, sure. Hell, I nearly forgot.
Okay. What in fresh hell is this?
This here's what we call a saloon door. Every joint has one.
I can see what it is. I'm asking you what on earth is doing on the front of my house. This isn't the Wild West. What even is the point in these doors? You can just slide underneath them.
Hey! Don't you yell at me, sir. I'm just doing my job.
What's all this? Why are you shouting at this man?
Look at our front door!
Well, this chap is obviously just one of those cowboy builders.
Before we get back to it, I'm actually homeless. I really need to find a living situation for tonight. The ones are going to be cold. And my living situation is kind of falling through, so everything's a little bit right now. And I'm a really, really, really good housemate. I'm clean, I'm quiet, and if Lauren or Alice try and tell you otherwise, they can go fuck themselves. Because I didn't shit on her cat, okay? It slid behind me. And it was all one massive misunderstanding. Anyway, if anyone has a room to rent, please, please, please come and see me after the show. All right, let's get back to it.
Tonight was great.
Yeah, it was amazing.
So, would you maybe want to come in for some coffee?
Oh, I don't drink coffee.
Good thing I don't have any then.
Shut
the fuck up! Oh my god, the entire night I've found it so hard to control myself around you! Get that dick milk in me, sir!
I'm sorry,
what? Get that ghost load in me, father figure. Now, what size am I going for here? It needs to be big enough so it covers the balls. I don't want to get pregnant.
I'm sorry?
You know, for when all the pecker snot comes oozing out.
Of my balls?
Obviously, where else?
That's not correct. I'm sorry to have to be the one to tell you this, but semen comes out of the penis.
But that's where piss comes out of, you fucking idiot.
So you're saying semen's excreted from the balls?
Well, duh. The balls begin vibrating and then, like, baby batter comes oozing out.
I don't think we're on the same page here.
Oh, aren't we? Now get over here and put that ghost load in your father finger.
I'm just gonna go.
Why do they always leave me?
I know you love listening to me, but we have a special guest speaker from our Splinchester campus who's here to teach you about the wonderful world of improv. So please welcome to the stage, Keshavi Saljani and our improvisers.
TV show will be a kids TV show, so if you have a name, you kids TV show. one. Be a fun made up one. Anything. Where's my socks? Where's my socks? Great. Change. Okay, the name of a soap opera. A brand new, like, your own soap opera.
Guy Fawkes.
Guy Fawkes. Okay. Okay, the name of an action film based on a mundane object.
Spaghetti.
Spaghetti.
Okay,
and
could
I have a news report
on
something absurd that's happened?
Fidel Castro becomes Prime Minister.
Oh, I've got Fidel Castro. Okay. Fidel Castro becomes
Prime Minister. News report. Change. That's what you are. A kids TV show called
Where's My Socks?
This is shocking. A soap opera.
Guy Fawkes.
Guy Fawkes. There we go. Guy Fawkes. Action movie.
Yes. So that's spaghetti.
I'm sorry for the patch.
So Fidel Castro has just become Prime Minister.
Change once. Helium.
Hey kids. I'm handy the hand. How's it going? Oh, that's a pretty dress.
It's sock puppets.
What?
Sock puppets. Yeah. That's
I know, just
the entire point of the show. You need
she let the socks go.
Well, where did you put the socks you're wearing on your hands?
I wear socks.
Did you buy socks especially?
Yeah, it's been my dream ever since I was a young boy. Me and my hand. We're best friends. I couldn't get to sleep as a young man. Be there lying in my bed.
It's okay, friend. I'm your friend.
That still doesn't explain why you've left the socks at home. Like the whole point in sock pump, sock is in the name. Crucial part of.
Look, I don't want him to. He's outcrowded the socks.
Is handy too big for the socks now. It's okay.
It's not his fault. It's not your
fault. It's
okay. You hadn't told me. Told me what?
My dear, did you hear?
What did I?
Somebody tried to blow up my husband.
What?
It's all about him. It's all about him. He went to work. And no, I can't.
What happened?
Somebody tried to blow up Rupert!
What? Why would they do such a thing?
Apparently there was this man from a foreign land.
Not one of those.
Your brother, did you not read the script?
No, director.
Spaghetti.
I'm sorry, I'm the director.
I just thought it was about spaghetti.
You're a big shot, okay? But that doesn't mean you get the right to pretend that I'm an equally valid actor in this show. Please, no, don't look at me like that. No, I'm literally... Is that a wig? Have they given you a... director? No, I'm supposed to be acting with Bruce Willis. He doesn't have hair like this.
Look, it's not hair, right? It's spaghetti.
No, it's spaghetti hard, die hard spaghetti.
Spaghetti hard, die hard spaghetti fun. Anyway, we're sort of running out of time. I'd like if you could just continue, please.
Okay, I'm sorry.
So we're shooting at the spaghetti? Or... Right. Die, spaghetti, you bloody Italian! Hello, I'm here outside Westminster. Shocking developments today in the news, because you're watching the news. If you want a different channel, then... tough.
Yes, Fidel Castro has just become Prime Minister. I'm just enjoying one of the free cigarettes that he's offered everyone. Cigars.
He's a good chap.
He's a good chap, that Fidel.
I like cigars.
I don't even like cigars that much.
Nah.
Oh, we are on the news, I forgot.
Yeah. How did he get into power again?
Don't get that. you know, he just sort of walked in there and said, "Hey, I'm Fidel Castro, back from the dead." We were like, "Wow, how did you do that? It must be pretty powerful." Anyway, in other news, swarms of bees have just attacked Westminster, and they're coming through that door right now.
Change. Robert Schofield.
Interesting. Change. No, sir, we're shooting the spaghetti.
Okay, alright. Scene 25, right?
Yes.
No, scene 26! Jesus, how many times?
Look.
We're shooting. This is the one where we shoot the dry spaghetti, not the wet spaghetti.
No, okay. It's dry spaghetti.
I'm so sorry.
Okay.
Right. Wait, can we do 37? I read that part of the script.
That's outside. That's an outside. We're on set.
Look, but the bit where I get turned into spaghetti, I can do that bit. I'm spaghetti. I can act. I'm Bruce Willis, man.
Right, you are very good at pretending to be spaghetti, Bruce Willis.
So we'll be doing 37?
Yeah, we'll just get a green screen in. Okay, scene 37. And action.
I'm spaghetti!
No! How could this happen to you? This isn't the man I fell in love with!
Cat! Beautiful! Didn't ask for anything more. I love you too.
Change.
And the bees have gotten in the room. We're going to keep reporting the news because that's our job. It's suspected that Fidel Castro let the bees in himself.
What would he do this to us?
As an act of defiance against the media.
Oh, wish I'd been a beekeeper now.
Yeah, that would really help in this situation. Oh, sorry, you just go.
Thank you very much. You just got up.
Thanks, buddy. Anyway, I think you've got this your bit of your sports.
Sports now.
Oh, sorry, I gotta act out the sports.
Okay. As you can see, this is football. Kicking! Lots of kicking. End of football. That's the sport. Over.
Yes, so now back to the bees. The current situation is that they've also been launched nationwide. So get a bee seed.
Weaponized bees. Who voted for this guy?
I mean, I did for one.
Oh,
change.
Yeah.
So yeah, we're gonna have to get like a wide angle.
Yeah, yeah, I think we just
cause, like,
zoom out a little bit.
He's a bit busy.
I mean, what we'd have to change the show because there's no sock puppet, so.
Well, you've still got your sock puppets, right?
Well, yeah, but like.
I just remember.
Handy was just—he was the main, he was the star. Can we do it without Handy?
I don't know. I guess I can talk to him.
I think you should try and convince him. We need him. He's the
glue
that holds this show together.
Yeah, I'll do this. We've got to do the show now. But I'll talk to him as soon as possible, but he's busy.
Yeah. Hey, kids! So, welcome back to Handy the Sock Puppet. In today's episode, Handy is asleep for half an hour.
Whoa, Handy!
What's up, I'm back, bitches!
I'm not telling you anything. No, I won't! I won't say anything. No! No! Stop! No, I won't! It's all about Robert. No! I knew it. Tell me more. I mean, you didn't actually tell me what to do, you just told me it's that Robert. That's all. No, don't do this to me! I found water in the valves. I heard they were magical valves, full of excitement.
They were just gunpowder. I was just
gunpowder, of course!
Told to put the gunpowder in to blow up Robin Schofield.
And what did you do with the gunpowder? How did you make them?
I mean, you just light it.
Light it, of course, fire!
mean, I'm not actually part of the group. They just paid me to... That's why I...
Paying people.
They all fled the country. You managed to catch me and put me in a dungeon because I wasn't really... I just... I'm not really a big part of this.
So tell me about Robert.
They wanted to blow him up, didn't they?
But what did he do?
I took
he hardly had a big role in Parliament. He was the janitor,
I'm sorry. I'm sorry. I've got it. Can you?
Yeah, well.
No, it's on my face.
Yeah.
Like, just by my lip.
Just, which
like up. Up and by my nose. They're just,
yeah,
thank
yeah,
you.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Why would they want to kill Robert? What has he done? He was a fantastic janitor. Never seen those toilets shine.
I think that's the problem because toilets are really, they're not sort of widespread now and people get jealous if the people have the toilets.
Of course.
So we
they
wanted,
wanted our toilets.
Change. There's no need to apologise to me.
Well, okay. I did rid the world of spaghetti.
Oh, you did?
Yes. No more spaghetti in this world. Pasta. So much pasta. I love it.
That's
fusilli! And the credits roll and beautiful. You're both stars. And the audience loves you.
Change.
And now for the news where you are. Fidel Castro has cloned himself and also appointed himself mayor of every county. He's also decided to position himself in the media, so I have my new co-host with me. How are you doing, Fidel?
What's that?
What's the weather like? Over in Cuba.
Cigars!
We'll be right back after these questions.
Cigars!
Cheers!
And we're not even all here yet. So can we introduce the rest of us to the stage? With a clap. And we've got all on stage, we're all here. We've got Sharon, James, Ash, James again, B, Will, Eleanor, Finn and Emmy. And I'm Katie, if you didn't know. But we're introduced, it's fine. We're acquainted. And now you're acquainted with all these lovely people. And then we're going to play another game with you guys, which is scenes, which is where I get two improvisers up front. He's an improviser. And I get a random location or relationship from yourselves, and they will base a whole scene off of whatever you say. So can I please get a relationship for
Medieval Knight and Squire.
Shark and Hunter.
Joe Rogan podcast.
We'll do the Shark and Hunter. You're Shark and Hunter.
I'm gonna get you. Oh, I got ya. You've been hunted.
Bagpipes.
now been English in Scotland. And I believed it.
Yeah, this is. It's like the whole landscape's out to get us.
Cue the lightning!
No! No! Jenny, are you alright?
Rock slide!
Jenny! Ow! No, we have to move! We have to move! Come on! I'm bleeding!
We need more people coming in the mountain!
Thank you,
call an
ambulance.
If those Englishmen get to the top of the mountain, we're all done for! I'll take over!
At least you're dead! Alright, I didn't know that!
Me too!
Who are you? I can't see you!
Can't I see you?
You wanna fucking go?
Fucking climb on there!
I'm all being relaxed. Get out of the way!
Oh, that was a long trip on the boat.
Actually, I'm too tired to fly.
You look like a nice guy.
Yeah, you're
both at the same time.
Okay.
I'm gonna tap you both at the same time and then we're gonna start.
Woo!
Do hate you.
It's like
can you say that again a bit louder? I'm not sure the live stream caught that.
No, I hear what you're saying, I understand. I'm just going to do a quick Google search. Yeah. WebMD says it's cancer.
Look, I hear the same thing every day. Yeah, killed your dad, fucked your dog, arch nemesis the Queen. Same thing.
So I've looked up some of the things you've been talking about and it says you might have network connectivity problems.
Have you tried using essential oils? I would diagnose schizophrenia, but I'm in two minds about it.
Well, the healing crystal seems to work for people's back pain, so it'll probably work here.
I don't know if it'll help, but I can do river dance.
Thank you very much. We've been improv. Woo!
One more round of applause for our improv
guys. Wow, guys, that was a lot of fun. Maybe even too much fun. Guys, I think that was too much fun. Let's take 15 minutes to cool down for the second part of the lecture. Something about not getting paid. It's not my fault, we're given shit all to begin with.
I guess that's what you get when you're working with a bunch of
amateurs! Fun little life lessons, huh? Okay, well, I understand it's very easy to get homesick at university. You're in a new place, surrounded by strange new people, so it's essential to stay in contact with your family.
More importantly, they're a reliable source of that sweet, sweet moolah and a reliable clothes washing service.
Anyway, hopefully these next few clips will remind you a little bit of your families.
Fuck you, I hate you!
Shut up, I hate you too!
Your mum.
No, your mum!
No, your mum.
No, your mum!
No! My mum! Am I right?
Shut up, you're a Freud PhD! We're trying to warn you!
Shit.
Oh no, my roots are planted now. I can't be repotted.
Fine then, I'll just cut you down.
No, you can't. Don't you remember? You said we need to stop cutting down trees.
I'm sure he's okay, but his parents, I've met them a couple of times in the school run, and I don't trust them.
I know Sandra, but he's Jimmy's best friend, and you're always so judgy. I'm sure his parents are fine. You thought that Fred's parents were horrible. They baked us that delicious cake.
Yeah, and they wrote "die bitch wankers" on it in icing.
I remember. It was buttercream, Jimmy's favourite. Besides, I'm just trying to see the best in people. Like, you didn't like their teacher, Mrs. Mitchell, because she was late, what, once? Like,
Molly. She was arrested for touching kids. That's why I thought she was a terrible teacher.
I don't know, maybe she was just being friendly. Like.
Jimmy, are you okay? Who hurt you?
Were you and Tommy playing too rough?
Oh, no. Mrs. Mitchell was angry at me. Can I shift my room?
See, Sandra, that's like the opposite of being into kids.
I know. I don't want Jimmy falling into the wrong crowd.
Yeah, I know you well. And, you know, maybe you're right about Fred's parents and Mrs. Mitchell, but this Tommy seems like a really good kid.
Yeah, it's nice to have someone in Jimmy's life who won't hurt him and...
I want my mummy. I want my daddy.
What the fuck?
I killed him. Dad, disrespect me.
He said I had cuties.
That doesn't mean you have to shoot him.
Don't you get it, Mother's dearest? Fred's parents never sent you that cake. I did. I made up all the lies about Mrs. Mitchell as well. All I ever wanted was to hurt you. He's just collateral damage.
Why?
It was 4 years ago, this very day. I entered the kitchen upon returning home from my first day at school. And I was a hungry boy. I sat in the house until I found a delicious packet of M&Ms to take to the cupboard to eat by myself. When you took them from me, you claimed I would ruin my appetite. I swore that day I would make you suffer. And
me? What the fuck? Oh, you always fuck it up.
I know. It's just parenting stuff. It's difficult. It doesn't exactly come with a manual, does it?
Right, well, I'll call the adoption agency tomorrow, get some new ones, and guess start again. It's taken us fucking 5 times already.
Jesus. Oh well. Wine?
Life advice is all about the coolest shape out there, the food pyramid! That's right. Who would have thought it'd be possible to let yourself go when under the immense stress of having to cook for the first time? But hey, listen kids, we're here to help. Just remember my golden rule. Just because it has potatoes in, doesn't make vodka one of your 5 a day.
I love wet toast.
Now please don't hurt my kids.
Lactose is available from all good supermarkets, hardware stores, and sex shops for only $19.99. Choose a great start to your day, choose a moist throat, choose Lactose! And for a limited time only, you get a free spoon with all purchases over $299.99.
Lactose just applies to the website for more details. The Lactose company cannot be held liable for any injuries sustained when using a Lactose toaster.
I'm so lucky to be dating an optician.
Oh, stop it, you. It's just a free eye test. Take a seat. Okay, can you read the top line for me?
I.
And the next?
A-M.
Good. And the next?
B-R-E-O-L-I-N-G? Breeling B...
Try again.
B-R-E... Oh, it's an A. Bree? Wait a minute. Am I breaking up with you? I didn't see that coming. Hey, Ash, it's sunny out. Don't forget your UV protection.
Oh, thanks. Totally forgot.
Much better.
Tasty fishes not get burnt.
So what kind of stuff are you doing here? Is it like, is it flu? Is it like jabs? Like, I don't know, do you do tetanus?
Yeah, anything you like.
Excuse me, mate. Can you hurry up? I'm gonna get my hit now, and a shot of a bullet is the only thing that's gonna do it for me.
Oh, fuck,
I'm sorry, sir, did you say Ebola?
Yes, yes!
I'm afraid the waiting list for Ebola is particularly long. You're looking at about 3 years.
What? No, I need a hit now!
Well, I'm sorry, but it's our strongest alternate infection. I can give you a hit of the common cold. Nobody seems to care about that anymore.
A common cold? What do you think I am, some common customer? I've been using Infect Plus for years. I deserve my bonus infection.
I'm afraid this only has 6 stamps on it, sir. That'll get you a free infection of tetanus.
Tetanus? I've already had tetanus!
Well, then I'm afraid we can't help. Ah! That is a very nasty cough you've got there, sir. Do you know what it is?
No, not at all. I just know I've got to get rid of it somehow.
It looks very nasty.
It does. Could be a new infection. We could put it straight in our infection banks. I'm sure to get a promotion.
So, what?
Excuse me. This man wishes to donate a new infection.
No! I want the first hit of it!
Thank you.
Not young bucks like us. Young bucks like us like to drink squash.
Squash?
That's right. Not just any squash. No, no. Real fucks like us like to drink squavom. The new vomit-flavored anything drink. Vomit it up, drink it back up again. Allow me to break it down for you. Squavom, squavom, squavom. Had a spag bowl for dinner. Now I'm drinking it up. Squavom, squavom. Oh my God, is that Beyonce? Hi, I'm Beyonce and I drink squavom. The new vomit flavored drink. You like squavom, boy?
Squavom, squavom, squavom. Look at that. Got big butt drinking vomit.
Work site, mate.
Great. You're the worst of a bloody lot! You're spits on the good name of this business. And look, what have you been doing with the machine? The sprockets and the flywheel, they're all out of whack. You've got to treat her gently, you clod. And let me have a go.
No, you really shouldn't be doing it like that. For him, mate.
Oh God, no!
Oh fuck, his arms come off! Oh shit! Oh fuck! There's blood everywhere! Someone call 999 something!
Oh God, no! This is my arm. The arm I used to masturbate. I mean, being my pet. God, the hubris.
Drink this.
Thank you.
Baraka, no, they too tough.
Is here to hold your hand every step of the way. We've got careers fairs, one-on-one counsellors, and if all else fails, you can wait for free money from student finance. Well, hopefully these few clips will teach you how to get a job.
Up here, if that's okay. How did you hear about this position?
Was it a job site? We advertise on Indeed quite a lot, and it'd be really helpful for our records.
You think I'd tell you over my dead body?
Excuse me?
You heard me, pig, so go on, run along and tell your master that whatever he wants, he's not gonna get it from me.
All right. So what do you know about the company?
I don't know anything, and even if I did, like, I'd fess up to it. I'd never betray my friends like that.
Listen, these questions are just a formality, and between you and me, we already pegged you as our top candidate, so you could just please tell us why we should hire you?
Fuck you.
Jesus, is that blood? I didn't touch you.
It ain't cranberry sauce, that's all I'm saying. You bozos do not know who you're messing with. My buddies will have already noticed I'm gone, and when they get their hands on you, wouldn't want to be in your shoes, that's all I'm saying. I mean, you call this torture?
Torture? I think there's been some kind of mistake. We're an electronics store. You applied here last week, see?
You think you can wheedle information out of me by bluffing? Come on, man, I know your fucking games. It's gonna take a lot more than that to break me.
Look, mate, I can see that you're clearly going through something right now, but if we could just run through some of your strengths and weaknesses before we wrap it up, that'd be awesome.
Yeah, that's a good one. So I'd probably say that my greatest weakness is pretending to be detained as part of the violent interrogation when faced with benign questioning. Yeah, that's my answer.
Oh, I get it. You're funny. I suppose a good sense of humor can be vital in the workplace. What's your availability?
You idiots forgot to check my pockets for tools! The naivety to think that ropes could hold
there
me!
There are no ropes. Nobody is trying to restrain you. Please, or I'll have to call security. Would you just calm down?
Oh, I'm so done answering your stupid fucking questions! Oh, hi, baby. I'm just finishing up the interview now. It's actually going really well. I think I've got a good feeling about this one. Yeah, see you later.
Today's gonna be a good day. Sure hope nobody mentions my love of feet.
Hello, aren't you Quentin Tarantino? Director of such films as
Reservoir Dogs, 1992, Pulp Fiction, 1994, Jackie Brown, 1997, Kill Bill, Volume 1, 2003, Kill Bill Volume 2, 2004, Inglourious Basterds, 2009, The Hateful Eight, Year of Our Lord, 2012. Django Unchained, oh wait, I messed up. Django Unchained, that was 2012. Hateful Eight was 2015. And of course, who could forget? Once Upon a Time in Hollywood, 2019.
How's your foot finish?
Okay, ready guys?
Yeah.
We have to say the prayer before we begin. We call upon the goddess of unreasonable middle-aged women with shit haircuts, stuck in a sexless marriage. Queen of all Facebook boomer memes, we ask that you fill the room with your negative spirit.
Is someone there? Yes.
What is your name?
No, fuck this, guys. This is insane. I'm out of here.
No, wait. I think she's trying to tell us something.
What do you want, Karen? to speak.
Manager!
What do you want, Karen? Who has wronged you? Me! What can I have done?
On the 6th of October, 2016, you served me coffee. Do you remember?
No.
Of course you don't remember!
What was wrong with the coffee?
Oh, it was too hot!
That's one small step for man, one giant leap for mankind. Buzz, you gotta come out and see this place.
Wow, this is way cooler than I could have imagined.
I know. After decades of intense training, we finally made it. The moon. Just take a look around. Soak it all.
Racist shit, right?
I am not. My name.
Hey guys. Okay, it's fine. I promise. Okay, I wrote that one. I'm sorry, okay, let's just get back on with the lecture. Our next set of clips are all about crime, and it's fairly simple. Don't do it. You read the laws, and you don't break them. Now, watch out. I've hidden a little joke at the end of these sketches, so get a firm grasp of your socks so they don't get blown off.
You now, Batman.
Hello, Joker.
Why, Batman, you're soaking wet, or should I say, Bathman? Oh, you like it? You could try to run now, feeling like a bat out of hell. Getting here is easier than after Bat an Island.
Oh, you Joker, you.
Oh, Batman, give me the confidence I need. I'm about to stand.
Please, support the arts. Prevent crime. Thank you.
Hello,
saying it was you. I just want to get to the bottom of who did this. Because quite frankly, it brought the annual meeting of the Association of Nudists into disrepute.
Well, it wasn't me. I mean, first of all, nobody's drunk punch since the late 90s. And secondly, I don't even know where you'd buy Viagra.
Nothing.
You just sneezed, didn't you?
No, God, I would never sneeze.
Do you know what you've done?
Guys, it was just a sneeze. You'll be fine.
No, you've killed us all. We're all going to get sick and die.
Don't you remember the Black Death? One day, somebody in Europe sneezed, and the next day, everybody died.
I mean, it's not quite accurate.
Holy shit, he had the plague! I thought it was just airborne AIDS.
Do not have the plague or AIDS.
Oh, we're fucked. We're fucked. We're so fucked. I've never been fucked so hard in my life.
Is that really how you want to say that?
Look, guys, I expect this, right? I'll go out, I'll get some Nurofen. It'll be all good. All good in the hood. Why? No one even knows I've sneezed.
Go out, you'll spread it to everybody, they'll trace it back here, and then they will kill us.
No one even knows I've sneezed!
They have eyes everywhere, man. No place to hide. What did I tell you?
Shut up, it's probably the Christian Union I texted for a toasty an hour ago.
Wait!
What?
What did you get from toasty?
Out of the way! Into the room! Get down on the ground!
Jesus Christ, which one?
All of them! Now calm down! We're from the Bureau of Plague Control Team. We've heard reports of an outbreak. In this very room.
How is that even possible?
There's eyes everywhere, man!
I told you! Wait, is it true Obama's not American?
Of course Obama's American. But the moon is fake.
Look! You're safe now! We're gonna take you to quarantine! Now go with us! Move! Move your ass! Let's go!
Alright, alright. I'll see you guys later.
That wasn't suspicious at all. That was probably nothing.
Guys, I think he's safe. Come on!
Stay and hide here forever, Abby. We've got to call someone and let us know we're here so they can come rescue us.
Yeah. Right. Just keep it down. Hello? Is this the police? I'd like to report.
A sketcher!
Hello. That's the end of the introductory lecture. If you do physics, you'll see me teaching maths and shit next week.
Hey guys, thanks for watching the show. Make sure you click the subscribe button, like it, comment, and ring the bell for more videos.